Hello student, welcome back to our computer class. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is chapter number 6, Internet Ethics and Safeguard. So all of you know internet? Yes, with the help of this internet we can search so many things with the help of this internet related to our topics, right? We can chat, we can use video, we can see each other with the help of this internet, we can do video calls, we can chat, okay? All these things happen with the help of this internet. Now we are going to study in this chapter about the internet. Then ethics and safeguard means then how to use the internet, okay? What is the proper, how to use this internet properly, okay? What should be a correct one, what should be a wrong one in the internet, and the safeguard, how to use internet safely, okay? All these things we are going to see in this chapter, that is in our chapter number 6, Internet Ethics and Safeguard. So let's start. Internet also called net. All of you know that mostly we will say the net, okay? So the internet also called net, all of you know that. This internet is one of the largest network that links million or trillions of computers all over the world. So internet connect the millions or trillions computer, okay, all over the world. So that's why we can do a video conferences, then we can chat, okay, we can chat with videos. So all this, or we can search different things on a internet, okay. So with the help of this net, it will link to the million or trillions of computer. Then the next is access this network via communication device like and mediums. We can say device or mediums such as cable, modem, telephone lines and satellite. So we can access this internet with the help of cables, okay. So most of you have seen that, most those who have a net in their houses, okay, so they use a cable for that, okay. They will provide an internet with the help of cables, or sometime they are use a modem. Now we are using a Wi-Fi, right? Wi-Fi modem we are going to use nowadays. Then there is a telephone lines also. Through telephone lines also it will provide the internet like BSNL, okay. So it will provide you like BSNL telephone lines, okay, that it will also provide you internet and satellite. So the satellite will help to provide or to access this internet, getting. Then it enable to read the latest news, do search, shops, communications, listen to music, play games, access variety of information. All of you know this, with the help of internet, okay, we can see, watch or read the latest news. Then we also do a search. Yes, searching we can do with the help of internet to our related topic. Then shop. Yes, we can do grocery shoppings. Okay, grocery shoppings we can do nowadays online. Okay, then other shoppings also. Communication that we can chat. Okay. We can chat whether it is a message or video chat, we can do like this, we can communicate. Then listen to music, we can with the help of internet we can listen to a different music, play a games by downloading it through internet, access like this we can access variety of information with the help of this internet, getting. Now next is protecting yourself from potential threat on web. So what is meant by potential threat on web means the warnings on web. While using internet you should take a precautions, okay. So it means understanding and preventing a number of security and privacy problems while using internet, okay. So you should, when you do anything on internet, okay, sending personal data, all that thing, you should prevent a security, okay. Your internet, when you are sending your personal details, you should know the securities, okay, that you are sending your personal details through a secure website, okay. Privacy problems while using internet. So when you send personal information like bank details or credit card number over the internet. All of you know nowadays we are doing a transaction, bank transaction online, or also we are doing a shopping online, okay? At that time, the personal information, okay, the personal information you have fill on in that, okay, you should know that you are using the secure site for your bank transaction or even your online shopping, okay? Otherwise, what will happen if you don't take any major precaution to protect yourself from potential threat in the cyber world, your computer would become the target of cyber crimes. If you are not take any precautions, what will happen with your computer? Your computer will become the target of cyber crime. Crime can be happen, okay? And whatever the crime will be happen in the internet, it's called cyber crime. So what is cyber crime? Cyber crime means when a person illegally access your computer for malicious reasons, okay? So another person will hack your data, okay? Hack your data. Have you seen that when you have done most of the time you have heard these things, that somebody will tell from my account this much money will deducted, okay? What it is? It is nothing but the cyber crime, okay? So cyber crime means when a person illegally access your computer, okay, and it will use a wrong way or wrong thing, it's called cyber crimes. Getting? Yes. Now the next is spyware. So what is meant by spy? All of you know spy. Yes, like detective, okay, who will keep an eye on you, okay? So this is a spyware. You have learned about viruses, how the different viruses you have seen, how they are corrupted our computer, okay? So like this on internet also there are different programs, okay? So one of them is spyware. So it is also a software program, okay? So this spyware is also a software program that get installed on our computer without our knowledge and concern. So this spyware is a program that get installed in our computer without knowing us, okay? It can be downloaded from website, email messages, instant message and direct file sharing, okay? So when you share a file, okay, at that time also it will get installed, okay? Or we can say through website also it will get download, or email messages, that the email messages you don't know from where it will send, okay? And you try to open it, okay? At that time also this spyware will install in your computer, okay? Or by direct sharing the files. This program secretly gathers data from computer, steals password, display ads and take control of web browser. Now how this spyware will work, that it will this program secretly gathered, okay, and gathers data from computer, okay, it will collect your data from your computer, okay, steal your what is your computer password, okay, it will steal your password. You have seen there when you open a website it will display ads, okay? So like this also this will display and take control of your web browser. Means it will see which web browser you are watching, okay, which web browser you have seen now, all this thing this spyware will do. So we have to take a precaution, okay? So what precaution you have to take? Use an internet security program to protect from spyware and other security risk. You also in viruses also you have seen the securities, okay, to protect from viruses. So here also for internet also there are the, you have to use a internet security programs like WikiHeal, that it will provide protection to your computer as well as it also provide the internet security. So like this software you have to use, okay, to protect from internet spywares, okay, and other security risks. Install personal firewall. Firewall again, what is firewall? It is also a security, okay? So firewall is also one type of program that it will prevent from internet spywares, okay? So you have to install personal firewalls, okay? Do not accept or open any doubtful error dialog box, like ad will come, okay? then if you click on that ad, okay, what will happen? That maybe it will be a spyware, it will get installed in your computer. So do not accept or open any doubtful error dialog box. Do not accept free deals. All of you know there will come a free deals. Okay, now seasons period, now a festival period is going on. Okay, at that time you can see this deal, that deal. Okay, free deal will be offer you. So do not accept that free deals. Always carefully read the end user license agreement. Now when you install any programs on your computer, okay, from internet, there will be a license agreement. You tick on and you go to the next. Okay, at that time what is the license agreements are there, you have to read it carefully, then only you have to take it. Okay, so all this precaution you have to take in to protect from spyware. Getting? Yes. What is spyware and what precaution we have to take? Yes. Okay, now the next is pop-up ad. So pop-up ad is a sort of advertisement that disturbs web browser by appearing in a separate browser window on top of current window. So when you are working on your tab on your PC using internet, okay, or you are going to search, at that time you have seen that some ad will appear on the top of your window. Okay, so this is called a pop-up ad. These pop-ups are irritated and may cause damage because clicking item in the pop-up window can cause spyware or viruses to be installed on computer. When this ad will appear on your window, it will come on the top or sometime it will come on in the bottom of your web page. Okay, so when you click on this pop-up ad, what will happen? That it will cause a spyware or viruses. Okay, it will cause spyware or viruses will install on computers. Okay, so don't click on that pop-up ad. So what precaution we have to take? We have to take that we can use a pop-up blocker to block pop-up ads in the browser. What we can do to protect from that pop-up ad? We have to use a pop-up blocker. So next time when you will work on internet, this pop-up ad will not appear on your window. So you have to use a pop-up blocker to block the pop-up ads. Getting pop-up ad? Yes. Okay. Now the next is spam. So email spam, also known as junk mail. So all of you have your mail account, email account. Okay. If not, see. In email account, okay, there is some information like inbox, sent mail, thrash. There is also one content called spam. Okay, you can see it on your email ID also. Okay, so this email spam, also known as a junk mail. Okay, sending unwanted messages by spammer to a large number of recipients. So in this spam there is unwanted messages in this spam. Okay, so when you open it, you can see that there will be a unwanted messages. Okay, it will not send from the person who you know. Okay, it will be the unwanted message sent by a spammer and to a large number of participants. Used to deliver email that contain viruses and target attacks at obtaining sensitive personal identificational information. So with the help of this spam, okay, it is used to deliver emails that contain viruses. So in this spam they can send the email which also contain the viruses. Okay, it contains the viruses and target attacks at obtaining sensitive. So what will happen when it will enter your computer? Okay, it will attack at your obtaining sensitive and personal identification information. It also hack your information. So you don't have to click on these spams. Okay, you have to protect yourself from these spams. just you have, when you see, when you click on this spam, and you will see the different mails, okay, from the unknown senders. Don't open it, okay, don't open it, otherwise it will be a viruses and that will attack to your personal identification. Getting? So what precaution you have to take for to prevent from spams? So you have to sign up for email filter through ISP or use anti-spam program. Okay, so if you want, if you don't want to access like this spams, not to come like this spam will not come to your mail, so what you have to do, you have to sign up from email filter through ISP, okay, or use anti-spam program you can use. Do not click link in spam or reply spam, okay. Whatever the message will come in a spam, don't click on it or reply to that message. Suspect spam, do not respond, just delete it, okay. So the spam emails will be, that will come in your email ID, okay, just delete it, don't respond it. Keep security software up to date. Whatever the security software you are using, like firewall, Quick Heal, okay, you have to update time to time that security software, okay, to protect you, your computer, from internet, from net viruses. Getting this? Yes, getting all of you? Yes. What is spam and how to protect from this spam? Yes. Okay, now the next attack is phishing is a scam in which you will receive an official or legitimate looking email message that attempt obtaining your personal or financial information. So phishing is also one type of attack, scam, that you will receive through your email messages, okay, and this will attempt obtain your personal. If you open this email, okay, that it will, this will attack on your PC and it will obtain your personal or financial information, okay. Message look legal and request you to update your credit card numbers, bank account numbers, password or other private informations. So what, how it will look like? It will looks like a legal, okay. Legal means that your known website, you will look like that it will come from your known website, like from, you have seen that many messages has come from bank, okay. You see that there will be a, and they told you to update your credit card numbers, bank account numbers or other private information. They ask you, okay, like Aadhaar number, PAN number, okay, like this. So like this it will send you a messages, okay. This scam can execute via email messages, website and even on the phone. So nowadays you also have seen in the ad that they told you, when you are watching a TV, there is a ad, you have seen that there, don't share your personal information, okay, don't share your credit card numbers, account numbers, okay, like this. So this phishing can execute via email message. They will do this like by sending you email messages through website also, or even you, they can call you on your phones by telling that to update your credit numbers, bank accounts, okay, all this. It is called a phishing. Now how to prevent from this phishing, okay, what a precaution to be take to prevent from this phishing. So to prevent receive an email message from someone requesting you to verify online account or financial information, do not reply with this information. So any mail you have received from who is asking you for, requesting you to verify your online account, financial information, so do not reply to that messages. Receive a phone call from someone claiming to be from a legitimate companies or banks, record caller name and time of the call. Do not disclose personal or financial information to the caller. Now only I have told you that they will call you and ask you for to verify to update your credit card numbers, account numbers, okay, and to share the Aadhaar card numbers. So at that time, don't tell them or don't disclose your personal or financial information to that caller. Don't give your all these numbers, okay, whether it is a credit card, bank account or any other information, Aadhaar card, PAN card, okay. Never click on link in email messages. So whenever you will receive these messages, don't click on that link, okay. Don't click on that link that provided on your email messages. While visiting bank website, type web address correctly. While you are using, while transaction or any other thing you want to do with your bank web, so at that time you have to type your bank website correctly, okay. You have to type your bank website correctly. Enable phishing filter in your browser. There is a filter, okay. So you have to enable that phishing filter in your browser when you are using the internet, okay. Enable the phishing filter in your browsers, getting. So these are the precaution you have to take for a phishing attack, okay. Getting all of you, what is phishing attack and what the precaution we have to take? Yes, okay. So in today's class we have learned little about internet and we also learn about the different threats. So in this class we have learned about spyware, pop-up ad, spam and phishing, and how to protect from them, what precaution we should take to prevent from these threats. All these things we have learned in this class. So in next class we are going to learn more about the threats, more different sets we are going to learn. Till then you have to revise all this thing what we have learned in this class. Till then, take care. See you in next class. Thank you.